Professor Dr. Abdul Rashid, right? Quite illustrious, So PhD in Special Information Science System, Geographical Information System, Professor Department of Biological and Agriculture. So perhaps I invite you to speak now.
Thank you very much, Jeffrey. First and foremost, I would like to draw your attention to all of you. Today you are part of history. Today's date will go down in the history books of Maluku and Malaysia. Very, very important day. Give yourself a big applause. You are the nucleus that is going to build the transformation of Kuala Lumpur. And today, most of you I see are seniors. I consider senior, right? At the same time, I see hope with also some young people around. In the point of inclusivity, I hope eventually as we grow, we also have a youth division. We need to bring in the young people. They are the majority citizen of Kuala Lumpur. We are moving forward because we got the realization, but we have to bring in them sooner or later. The sooner the better. Okay, this is my initial observation. Now, going on from the Rule 5, I'm just surprised. The Rule 5, just to inform the people that development going to take place in their vicinity, in their neighborhood. Now, we have a democratic system. We have election. Now, a simple appeal will be for our MPs, the one next to me right here. Please, can you ask the government, bring it to the next cabinet meeting? All citizens in the Taman must be informed of any development. This is a basic fundamental right. No need to go so much onto so many technicalities. Rule 5 was taken out, so we lost it. So now we realize it, let's bring it back. It's very important agenda, most important agenda. Doesn't matter what you call it, Rule 5 or Rule 10 or Rule Common Sense. All citizens, all residents must be informed. Suddenly I see at the back of my house, oh, tractors moving, a hill being bulldozed. Okay, what happens? You know, we call in the relevant authorities, even call the directors, please look at the slope. Slope is more than 5 degrees. No EIA. Okay? And it is not allowed to develop such slope, but they have permission. What's happening? So these are pertinent questions, and we tell the authorities. But how do we go about it? As the association. Then we need the organization. So we have, in our case, we have our own what we call persatuan penduduk. But how prepared are we to address these issues? When you call a meeting, how many of your members or expo come and attend the meeting? How many of them are pulling with their heart this meeting? I even have on record, some persatuan head will say that I am not interested to write a complaint to DGKL. So this is the thinking that we have to transform. The thinking of the citizens, of the residents. We have to transform the thinking to think cohesively, to think in favor of the residents. Those who want to contribute, those who want to move the society forward, they should be up there. And be careful, be careful. We are dealing with people with a lot of power and influence. People who develop, they have also their contacts. So you don't want the wrong connections sitting in your persatuan. You want to elect the right people. And after that, think about it. In your persatuan, how well educated are they? How well educated are they in moving forward the society, moving forward the persatuan? We are a country, 60 plus years of independence. Have we educated our masses on the value of improving our society? Not for personal gain, but for the gain of our generation, for our gain for the generation to come, and for the unborn generations. You realize, we inherit the world, not for ourselves. What did we get from our forefathers, and what are we going to give to our children and grandchildren? Is it the same world? If they come into the world, no student, because we demolish whatever bushes behind our house. Isn't that something you feel terribly ashamed about? I think we need to mobilize. We need to mobilize the people. When the people are mobilized, like you guys here, now we are 50 over for Satwa, when we got 100 over, I bet with you, every politician will listen to you because you are the voice of the people. At the moment, segregated, fragmented, don't speak as one voice. I think with that, yes, you did a great job and we're going in the right direction. Thank you very much.
A fantastic speech, eh? And all within 3 minutes. Okay, the next person that we are looking at